From nonsense to neuroscience, what's the worst noise in the world?
You know.
Yes.
I believe I've mentioned it before tonight. That would be Coldplay B-sides.
Applauding. No, quite a lot of people going, I like Coldplay. Yeah.
So we have some props where you can make some noises.
Oh, hello.
Let's have a look. So let's start with Nish and Alan. Let's... That's very irritating,
oh,
isn't it?
God. Wow.
Yeah.
All right, stop it.
Yep. Yeah. Oh. Do you remember what that is, Nish?
This is a vuvuzela.
It is a vuvuzela, yes.
Which ruined the 2010 World Cup.
It's a hideous noise, isn't it?
Well, luckily I have grade 7 in vuvuzela, so we're fine.
Oh, Alan. Fingers on the... That is awful.
I've got a mirror and this cube of white stuff. It's the most annoying sound in the world. Me on drugs. This is polystyrene.
Yes.
And...
So the Journal of Neuroscience did the top 10 most annoying sounds. Apparently the most annoying is a knife on a bottle. But we haven't been able to work out why that is. This one we can do. This is number 2. A fork.
Oh, God.
I got the power.
That's very unpleasant, isn't it?
I've got a... This
yes,
is the older...
That's the...
Ooh. What is worse than this is when it just goes... Doot.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
And then 4 minutes later goes...
Yeah. And you can't work out which one it is. It's somewhere in the house.
The thing I love about, like, any sort of smoke alarm is that we've advanced so far technologically and yet we still haven't got beyond the only way to solve a smoke alarm is to have a tea towel and just do this underneath it.
I was in a hotel once. I was a bit pissed. And I fell asleep on the bed in my clothes. And then I was woken up by this terrible noise in the room. I thought, what is that? It's kind of like this. And there was this thing on the ceiling, and I started hitting it with my shoe. as hard as I could. And then it fell off the ceiling, and it was dangling by a wire. And then I rang reception and go, there's a thing in my room making a terrible noise. And they said, that's the fire alarm, sir. Will you please evacuate? And I said, oh, just so you know, when it went off, it kind of fell from the ceiling. Then I went out on the street and I was the only person in clothes.
Shape is a raindrop.
We're doing a shape that I think would be a possible raindrop shape.
You are doing... Oh, dear! You've been doing so well. It's not pear-shaped or tear-shaped.
I'm going to do another one.
Yeah. I don't think we even thought of that one.
No? Should I do a cock and ball?
It will be your coat of arms if you decide to be knighted, won't it?
It's been so long. Perfect circle.
Here's the right answer. They used to use this thing that gravity made liquid completely spherical. They used to have huge towers. They were called shot towers. There was one in Waterloo until they built.
Make shot.
Shot, exactly, yeah. Huge one in America, in Baltimore, which was the tallest building in America until they built the Washington Monument. And they literally drop molten lead and it hits the water and it's just completely round by the time it hits the water. It seems extraordinary. You'd think when it hit the water it'd get flattened, but maybe someone will write in and explain, but not to me. And... ball bearings and various other things have utilised this marvellous fact about liquids turning spherical as they fall. Where might you bump into the world's biggest drip? No!
The biggest drip is in a cave?
It is in a cave, as
it would
goes.
Be a stalactite.
Is the right answer. Well done. Absolutely right.
Well done.
The Gruta Rei de Mato in South America. has the biggest of them all.
How big is it?
Vast is the answer.
Thanks, mate.
How big is it? Oh, very. If I was to quantify its bigness, we'd be doing it a disservice.
To say just how
bigly big the vastly big bigness of the dripping thing. Oh, I would feet, meters, anything. Throw me a f***ing bone for it.
The answer is actually about 20 meters long.
Thank you.
And they're between 18 and 20,000 years old. And the ones that go up are called
stalagmites. We've got a G in because they're in the ground. Stalactites are in the ceiling.
I was always taught tights hang down was the thing. Yeah, but it's, anyway.
Public school again.
Anyway, we didn't really understand about these things. But anyway.
Fry, put on the 15 denier and see me in my
What does that mean, anyway, denier? What's that?
It's a unit of sheerness of ladies' underparts. The stockings are sheer, yes. However sheer they are, it's rated that's in right. denier. What's the sheerest you can get?
Bare legs.
No, well, that is very...
No, tan. You can get tan.
That's sheer?
That's sheer. After 30 denier, they go into opaque.
So I see the higher the denier, the less sheer they are.
Yes.
I understand.
Fry, you oaf, those are fishnets!
It's got eight legs, sits in the middle of a spider's web, but is not a spider. Oh. Jo Brandt.
It, one and a half flies.
Wouldn't that be nine legs?
No, and a half has lost a leg. It's been eaten. In theory, that is right.
If, yes, it would, why?
I hate it when you try and help a spider. And it resists you, and then one of its legs comes off.
Just get on the annoying. Paper and go, oh. And Daddy Longlegs, they're even worse.
Yeah, you think the spider could do the six and the clockwise with its two legs?
It probably can easily. Yeah, it's laughing up its sleeve at this, if they have sleeves. Eight sleeves, it's laughing up its eight sleeves. This does seem very bizarre. It sits in the middle of a web, has eight legs, looks exactly like a spider, but it isn't a spider.
Is it an unlucky octopus?
A beached octopus.
Well, is given... it some sort of predator that wants to eat spiders? Is it one of those?
Actually, it's the reverse. It's a spider that wants to deter predators, so it creates a fake spider.
Yeah.
There. Oh. That's made of its dead skin, it's made of leaf mould, it's made of all kinds of bits and pieces. There you can see the sort of body. You only see four of the legs there. It's already making a woman in the audience wet herself.
Did someone just make that?
A spider did.
Oh, is that real?
Spiders make them. That's the point. They make them.
Is that to scale?
Well, it's almost in the sense that it's five times bigger than the actual spider. So the spider is quite small. It makes this enormous spider. And sometimes it lives in a pouch in the abdomen. And no one's quite sure why. They think it may be to deter predators because it looks too big, or that it may be to suggest to other spiders that you can't steal this web because it's occupied.
But it's like a scarecrow, really. Isn't it?
Basically, yeah. Or it turning your lights on in your house to get
just
burglars off.
Be a hobby.
Yes.
When your life is sitting in the corner of a shed eating flies,
you've got to
have something.
It is in the middle of the Peruvian jungle where there are not so many sheds.
They don't even eat them, do they? They drink them because they wrap them up in their silky web, and then the prey dissolves into a fluid, and then they suck it when it's a liquid thing.
That's good eating.
Yeah, isn't
it? Yeah. The amazing thing is, and this is really extraordinary, is that another species of spider altogether, as far away as you can virtually get on the planet, 11,000 or so miles away, across from Peru in the Philippines, does almost exactly the same thing. And nobody knows if that's convergent evolution or whether it's actually be a weird raft that managed to get all the way across that amount
it's
of work.
It's just God, Stephen. It's just God.
Just God. You overlooked that possibility.
Mysterious ways, mysterious ways.
Very mysterious ways. So that's the Peruvian spider that makes huge models of itself.
Are those spiders to scale?
Because I'm telling you now, Japan are going to be all over that.
Counting worms to monkeys that count. What job can even a monkey do? Yes, Joe.
Is it quantity surveying?
apologies to all quantity surveyors watching.
That's my brother.
Is your brother?
Does he survey quantities all day?
Yeah, sadly for
him. Do you get tired of surveying quantities? I mean, how many quantities can you survey in one day?
He can survey 47 quantities.
47 quantities? That's a lot of quantities. Wow. Well, no, I don't think monkeys can survey quantities.
They can count.
Yes.
The person who counts how many people are on the plane before you take off, that could be a monkey.
That would instill us all with confidence.
Just before take off, a small primate comes down the aisle with a clicker. And he also does the duty freeze because no one ever buys any.
In Thailand, there is a school.
A monkey school?
Yep. They have between 3 and 6 months of training, the pig-tailed macaques. Mm. And they end up working on a plantation where they can pick between 800 and 1,000 watts a day.
Bananas.
Not bananas, because they'd eat those, wouldn't they?
They would.
Coconuts.
Coconuts!
Between 800 and 1,000 coconuts a day they can pick. There they are. But it's very useful. It's a lot more than a human could, probably.
But do they count them as well?
Well, I don't... Those don't count, no.
Clicker in one
hand.
In the US, they use capuchin monkeys for a charity called Helping Hands, which assists people with disabilities, and they help with feeding, retrieving dropped items, changing compact discs, turning lights on and off.
Wow.
And in Tokyo, there's a tavern where... a traditional sake house, where macaques are employed to bring customers hot towels.
I don't want a hot towel off that fellow.
No, no, no. that is horrible.
Imagine that, the end of your bed at night. Yeah. Hot towel, sir. Oh, fuck off.
What does the S on Superman's chest stand for?
Love that noise. Super.
Yeah. So it's not an S.
Simon.
And they type that fast.
So in the 2013 film, Lois Lane actually asks Super... I don't know why I'm telling you.
Yeah, I don't either, but...
She actually asks Superman what the S stands for, and it's not an S, it's a Kryptonian symbol of hope. It just looks like an S by coincidence, apparently.
I should have known that.
You should have known that. Yes. What is... OK, let's try one you should know. Superman's real name is, of course...
Jor-El.
Oh, it's Kal-El.
Oh, Kal-El. Right, you're right. Jor-El's the dad?
Yeah.
Look at me, I'm the least Superman knowledgeable person
on this panel. How many episodes did you play Lois Lane?
Clearly not enough. I guess it was 4 years times 22, so was that 88, something like that. Yeah.
Just look at this picture of you. Can I just say, that picture of you was, at the time on the internet, the most downloaded image in the world.
Yeah, it was only because that was, like, the beginning of the internet.
No, doesn't she look amazing? Look at that picture, absolutely fantastic.
So why did you reveal it straight away? You should have had us sitting here for 20 minutes and it going...
Hanging
it now. Dial-up AOL.
Lois is not Superman's only love interest, so before...
Lana Lang.
Lana Lang. Same initials, so keep the tattoo, which I quite like. Very good. Because the best bit in the story is his disguise, isn't it? He only has glasses on, and then he takes them off.
Which, of course, is really why I know nothing, because if I was fooled by glasses on, glasses off... Wait, take your glasses off. Oh, my God, where did Sandi go?
Yes.
Somebody bring back Sandi. She's running the whole thing. Oh, thank God you're back. We were really lost there.
Superman's S stands for hope.